Good morning, everybody. I hope you're staying dry on this wet, wet Friday morning near Shakota, Oklahoma. We are getting some kind of rain, thunder and lightning, but you know, it's just beautiful all in its own way. And we were getting to the point where we could use some rain. The garden's coming up. Now it can get watered. All the fields are just green, and what cattle we have left are going to be pretty happy. So we thank the Lord for the sunshine. We thank Him for the rain. It's a wonderful day. I'm excited again, as I am every day, to see how the Lord's going to speak to us through His Word. We're going to read from John 9, and it's a wonderful chapter. I really love it personally, as I do all the other chapters. But if we can come to the Lord with an open and an expectant heart, He will fill it. He'll give us instruction. His Holy Spirit knows exactly what we need. But before we go on, I have a little announcement to make. So as you know, many of you know, we have a little podcast that we've been doing. Now, we've been slack the last, many months in doing them very regularly. And so we've been talking about that, thinking we need a specific topic or direction to go in regards to the podcast. Well, we have decided on one that we're going to try. And we need, first, our VIP members to help us out. I was thinking about all the different people from all over the world that are listening to our music. And it's humbling. We're just really blessed by the wide variety of people. I'm seriously, all over the world, not just in mainland USA, where our kind of music that we play kind of comes from. Might get into that more. It is rooted in other places, but anyhow, I'm going to get to the point. We would love to hear from our VIP members first about where you're from. And we'd like to make a podcast about where you're from, your hometown, or where you're living now. And if you could submit to us some of the bits of information that you would like us to talk about in that podcast about your hometown, we would love that. We would love to see pictures, information, background, you know, maybe who's famous from there, or the kind of things that you experienced growing up and how that's changed. All that kind of things. I know many of you, I believe, would love to have your home, town, or where you're living showcased on an Amundsen Family Music podcast. We would love to know, where are these people that are following us? We'd love that. Whether we feature your name in it or not, I guess might be up to you. Of course, we would love to. We would love to showcase exactly who you are. But I'm mostly thinking about where you're from. So here's the call. First of all, to our VIP members, any of you who would like to be involved in this, let me know. Send me information on where you're from, some background, some history, some fun facts, pictures, videos, whatever you can come up with and that you feel comfortable with sharing, let us know, and our family will incorporate that into a podcast specifically for where you're from. All right. If you need any more information, I'll be putting out more. Or you can ask me, you can email me, message me, phone me. And we're really excited about this. And so we would love to do that. Sweep over my soul. Sweep over my soul. Sweet Spirit, sweep over my soul. My rest.
rest is complete as I sit at your feet. Sweet Spirit, sweep over my soul. Sweep over my soul. Sweep over my soul. Sweet Spirit, sweep over my soul. My rest is complete as I sit at your feet. Sweet Spirit, sweep over my soul. Sweep over my soul. Sweep over my soul. Sweet Spirit, sweep over my soul. My life is made new by the work that you do. Sweet Spirit, sweep over my soul.
Yes, we need His sweet Spirit hovering over us every moment of the day. Amen. He's our closest friend, brother. He's our father, mother, and sister. He's everything to us if we'll just hold on to Him, cling to Him, trust in Him, be led by Him. Amen. All right, so we're going to go on in, say, John 9, and it's exciting. Let's just see what the Lord has in store for us. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you. We want to thank you for the sunshine. Thank you for the rain. Thank you for all good things that come from your hand. But most especially, we thank you for the sacrifice that you made for us, sending your Son to die on the cross for our sins, giving us access unto the Creator of the whole universe. Lord, we thank you for your word, which has never failed, which is always full of life. And Lord, we partake of that this morning and pray that you would just give us and provide for us that what we need through it. In Jesus' name, amen. So here we are, John 9. You know, I have to remind you once in a while, if you want to follow along, I'm in the King James Version. It's just what I grew up with. It's what I like, but I'm not legalistic about it. If you want to follow along in another translation, that's fine. What really matters is that we listen to the author of it, the Holy Spirit. And as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind from his birth. And his disciples asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Jesus answered, Neither hath this man sinned, nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him. I love that. Oh, I love that. I don't want to commentate much, but never question God's love for you. Never question about what have I done wrong. He's a wonderful, loving Heavenly Father. He will work the works in you, and that's His purpose. What I mean by that, what have I done wrong to deserve this or that? You know, my health, my financial situation. He'll guide us in those things, but He's also a forgiving God. I digress. I must work the works of Him that sent me while it is day. The night cometh when no man can work. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. When he had thus spoken, he spat on the ground and made clay of the spittle. And he anointed the eyes of the blind man with the clay. And said unto him, Go, wash in the pool of Siloam, which is by interpretation sent. He went his way therefore and washed, and came seeing. The neighbors therefore, when they which before had seen him that was blind, Is not this he that sat and begged? Some said, this is he. Others said, he is like him. But he said, I am he. Therefore, said they unto him, how were thine eyes opened? He answered and said, a man that is called Jesus made clay, and anointed mine eyes, and said unto me, go wash in the pool of Siloam and wash. Go to the pool of Siloam and wash. And I went and washed, and I received my sight. Then said they unto him, where is he? He said, I know not. They brought to the Pharisees him that aforetime was blind. Having trouble reading this morning. 14. And it was the Sabbath day when Jesus made the clay and opened his eyes. Then again the Pharisees also asked him how he had received his sight. He said unto them, he put clay upon mine eyes, and I washed, and do see. Therefore, said some of the Pharisees, this man is not of God, because he keepeth not the Sabbath day. Others said, how can a man that is a sinner do such miracles? And there was a division among them. They say unto the blind man again, what sayest thou of him that has opened thine eyes? He said, he is a prophet. But the Jews did not believe concerning him that he had been blind and received his sight until they called the parents of him that had received his sight. And they asked him, saying, is this your son, who ye say was born blind? How doth he now see? His parents answered them and said, we know that this is our son and that he was born blind. But by what means he now seeth, we know not. Or who hath opened his eyes, we know not. He is of age. Ask him. He shall speak for himself. These words spake his parents, because they feared the Jews. For the Jews had already agreed that if any man did confess that he was Christ, he should be put out of the synagogue. Therefore, said his parents, he is of age. Ask him. Then again called they the man that was blind, and said unto him, give God praise. We know that this man is a sinner. He answered and said, whether he be a sinner or no, I know not. One thing I know, that whereas I was blind, now I see. Then said they to him again, What did he to thee, that he opened he thine eyes? He answered them, I have already told you, and ye did not hear. Wherefore would you hear it again? Will you also be his disciples? Then they reviled him and said, thou art his disciple, but we are Moses' disciples. We know that God spake unto Moses. As for this fellow, we know not from whence he is. The man answered and said unto them, why, herein is a marvelous thing, that ye know not from whence he is, and yet he hath opened my eyes. Now we know that God heareth not sinners, but if any man be a worshipper of God, and doeth his will, him he heareth. Since the world began, was it not heard that any man opened the eyes of one that was born blind? If this man were not of God, he could do nothing. They answered and said unto him, thou wast altogether born in sin, and dost thou teach us? And they cast him out. Jesus heard that they had cast him out, and when he had found him, he said unto him, dost thou believe on the Son of God? He answered and said, who is he, Lord, that I might believe on him? And Jesus said unto him, thou hast both seen him, and it is he that talketh with thee. And he said, Lord, I believe. And he worshipped him. And Jesus said, for judgment I am come into this world, that they which see not might see, and that they which see might be made blind. Oh, God, help us. And some of the Pharisees which were with him heard these words and said unto him, are we blind also? Jesus said unto them, if ye were blind, ye should have no sin. But now ye say, we see, therefore your sin remaineth. I love that chapter. I just love the way the blind man answered. And God must have, by his Spirit, put those words in his heart to minister to the Pharisees. And just Thank the Lord. All right. I am going to try and get out of our music shack without getting too wet. And I hope you have a wonderful day. And again, VIP members, stay tuned for more information about our podcast idea. I would love to hear if you're interested in us highlighting where you're from. We would love to know more about it. And I know that there's so many interesting folk that are following us here on Facebook and YouTube and VIP. And we would love to showcase who is it that's listening to our music. All right? God bless you. Have a wonderful day.